Who do you want to be? The reporter or the creator? Hello, I'm Ranjan Kumar, founder Mystic Fusion International and Authentic Influence Coach. Well, here's something that I have been interested in for a very long time when I listen to people. Everyone I listen to has, you know, some stories to share. And if you listen to the stories of the people around you, you will get two kinds of stories. One, about something that happened to them. The other kind, which is mostly about something that they did or they created. And if you look into the eyes of these people, when they're sharing these stories with you, you know, I was listening to my father when he was sharing a few stories about those days when he was, young and he was in his work, and how did he used to deal with his superiors and his work and everything. I saw that, you know, glaze in his eyes. He would come alive when he would talk about everything that he was very proud of. But when I looked deep into what are those stories that people are very proud of when they share with others, these are the stories when they really created something, when they did something, when they did something that would make them happy, that would make them proud, that would make them feel like a creator. And then there are the other stories, we call them victim stories. When you listen to people when they're sharing these victim stories, you wouldn't find life in their eyes. You know, you can see through their eyes, and they would be pretending as if, you know, the passive seekers of life instead of being the source of life. And you can see through those moments, and people would be lifeless, and they would be talking as if they are a byproduct of something that has happened outside. They would be talking about the incidents, the accidents, the circumstances, the situations, the people around, you know, the problems around, the challenges around, where they didn't choose to do something, they didn't decide to do something, and they would list out everything because of which they were rendered helpless. They couldn't do anything. And at the end of the story, you would see that drained energy. You would see people talking about everything that they couldn't do because of any XYZ reason. Now, these people I would call are the reporters. They live the reported on life. They talk about everything that happened to them or everything that they were on the receiving end to. And then there are the creators. These are the people who talk about everything that's possible, everything that they dream about, everything that they would want to create, everything that they would love to do, everything that they would want to be, and everything that they're being in the moment. These people are the creators. And when I believe that, you know, every person has a creator and a reporter. It only depends upon who do you focus on mostly. And this is a choice, this is a decision. Who would you want to focus on? Would you want to focus on the reporter, or would you want to focus on the creator within? And it depends on your choice in the moment. At every point of time, you know, in each moment, the moment you have a thought, you have your magic wand in your hand. And that is your right to choose. Who would you want to focus on? Who would you decide to focus on? Would you want to decide to focus on the victim within, or would you want to focus on the creator within? But most people think that it's not something that they have control on. And that is where we lose focus, and we become the slave of the thought, we become the slave of the mind that we actually want to enslave. And it's very easy to get distracted in stories. And we mostly get distracted in the stories that we create in our own minds. So I would want to draw your attention to this right to choose. And I would want you to employ this right to choice and ask yourself, who would you want to be? Ask yourself, who do I want to be? Would I want to be the reporter, or would I want to be the creator? Why? Because, you know, imagine 20 years from now, imagine 30 years from now, and imagine that you are sharing your story with 1,000 young boys and girls listening to you. They are eager to listen to your stories. What kind of stories would you want to share with them? What kind of narrative would you want to show them that you have lived and you have created? Would it be a reported on life? Would you want to tell them that, you know, I couldn't do this, I couldn't do that because of these challenges, because of these, incidents that happened in my life, because of my boss, because of my wife, because of my kids, because of my family, because of my financial conditions? Are these the kind of stories that you would want to share with the younger generation? Or you would want to tell them that this is how I dreamed big, this is what I created, this is who I became, this is who I'm being, this is what I loved to do, this is what I love now to do, and this is what I am doing right now by being the kind of person who I am today. Imagine. If this one imagination can't move you to decide something, then I would want you to sit back and ponder, what are you doing here? Who are you being here? And what would you love to do? Because if you're not doing what you're loving to do, the other way is to love what you do. And for that to happen, you need to be someone. The question is, who are you being? Are you being a reporter or are you being the creator? And remember one thing, there is no excuse. Everyone is born a creator. It's only that we blindfold ourselves to escape from taking the responsibility of creating our own creation. I can see that you are a creator the way I am, the way your kids are, your family, your brothers and sisters are, and the way my kids are and my family members are. And remember one thing, you are a beautiful creation as well as the creator. Decide who do you want to be in the moment. Love you.